Hi and welcome to a new quick edit video, this time with my absolute favorite shot from my Dolomites trip. I am sure a lot of you know this location, it's called the Cicada. I waited here until sunset to catch some great colors. And now back home I want to further enhance those colors using Adobe Lightroom and Photoshop for the post-processing. So before I go on, here are the before and after images. Okay, the basic raw adjustments I'm doing in Lightroom, of course. First I'm activating the lens correction settings, then I'm going back to the top. And as said in the intro, I want to make this really, really colorful. So I'm going with the Adobe Landscape Profile, which will already boost the saturation a bit and it also helps bring back details in the darker areas of the image. Now for the white balance, I think I'm going with Daylight, since this adds this nice warm color tone to the picture. Then let's adjust the brightness of the photo a bit. First I want to increase the whites, since this image is a bit underexposed. Now of course the highlights did get quite a bit stronger. To prevent this I'm reducing them. And then I also want to increase the shadows. Okay, I really like the structure of those cliffs in the foreground. I also want to make those details a little bit more visible. I can do that by carefully increasing the texture. Okay, and then I also want to boost the vibrance. Okay, next I want to apply a small local adjustment. Therefore, I have already created a gradiated filter. As you can see, this will only affect the sky area. In my opinion, this area is way too bright, so I want to fix that by dropping the exposure. And I can also increase the contrast. Okay, now I have to do some color grading for this shot, actually more than usual. Let's start in the saturation tab first. For this shot I really don't need the yellow and the green color saturation, so I'm dropping them all the way down. I also want to get rid of some of the red, purple and magenta color tones, just because the back of the mountain does look a bit weird with those pink color tones all over it. Okay, then I also want to adjust the hues a little bit. Right now I don't like this purple color cast in the sky. I much rather have a blue sky for this image, so I can kind of fix that by dropping the purple hue. Okay, and then I'm switching to the luminance tab, where I want to brighten up those orange cliffs in the foreground. And of course I'm doing this by dragging up the orange luminance. And then to further darken the sky I can simply drop the blue luminance. Okay, and of course I'm applying a little bit of split toning. For the highlights I'm going with a nice warm color tone. Let's reduce the strength a bit. Okay, and for the shadows of course I'm going with the cold color tone. And again reduce the strength. Alright, and let's also sharpen the image real quick. And finally, I might want to go all the way down to the calibration tab to adjust the colors. So let's see, I might want to drop the blue primary hue just a little bit and also increase its saturation. This is really just a minor change, but it does make a big difference in my opinion. But I also don't want to overdo it here. That's it for the Lightroom part. Now I'm going to open this image in Photoshop to finish the editing. Alright, and first of course I need to fix a few things, mainly those ugly sensor spots, and therefore I'm using the spot healing brush. And then I want to get rid of this fence on the right side. Again, I'm just using the spot healing brush here. Then let's get rid of those people, again just with the spot healing brush. Then let's check the Nick collection for some nice effects. And first I want to go with the skylight filter, since this will add even more saturation to the sunset image. Of course, I need to be really careful with this one, since it's quite strong. Okay, I think something like this looks pretty nice. Good, then let's go through the Nick collection again. And this time I'm choosing the classical soft focus to give my image this soft look you can see right now. Now I just need to choose between those two methods. And this can be difficult from time to time. But in this case I think I'm choosing the third soft focus preset. Okay. And since I don't want to have this over the whole image, I'm going to apply a layer mask. And then I'm grabbing a black brush. And then I want to brush out certain areas, for example the foreground. And maybe also this little forest right here. And then some parts of this darker area. Okay. Now I think I can make this image a tiny bit darker, so I'm applying a brightness and contrast adjustment layer and I'm dropping the brightness and maybe also increase the contrast just a little bit. Okay. And as always, before I start overdoing this shot, I want to stop at this point. So if you have any questions regarding the editing or any suggestions for other videos, then please let me know in the comments, and thank you very much for watching this video.